Hello everybody, welcome back to Fifield Junction and welcome back to the Lima Class 37 project. We've got part 3 for you today. I know it's been a little while since we've visited this project, but we're finally back and we can finally carry on upgrading this loco and try and make it as best as we can. So obviously in the last couple of videos we've obviously serviced the loco, we've gotten it working, we've converted it to DCC, which is all working well. However, we can still improve the performance further, and that's what we're going to be doing today. So I have purchased one of the Strathpeather Junction CD motor kits, and we're going to be upgrading the motor in the loco today so we can try and get even more excellent performance out of the loco. Hopefully get it running quieter and smoother, although she is all running incredibly smoothly, but hopefully we'll get some quieter performance out of her. So that will be the aim of today's video. What I'm also going to do is I'm going to change the 8-pin socket in the loco as well. Whilst I do like using these particular 8-pin sockets, I want to try and maximise the amount of space in the loco as much as I can for things like speakers and the wiring for the lights and stuff. But if we just open up the kit, so if we just put the loco to one side, we'll just have a very quick look at the kit itself. So if we just tip everything out, there we go, we can put the bag to one side. So obviously the main thing we've got is we've got the actual motor itself, and it's very nicely already been fitted into the, I suppose, sort of converter, sort of a 3D printed converter piece, which is quite nice, so at least I won't have to worry about doing that. And then we've also got the two wires coming off. I'll probably treat the red as the right hand side of the motor and the black as the left hand side. So the conversion should be fairly easy. We've also got two gears, one of them is just a spare. We do need to trim the gear down side before we fit it, that's quite an important thing. And we've also got some heat shrink tubing, which is nice as well, so I use that, at least I won't have to use any of mine. I'll dismantle the old motor and I'll fit the new motor, and then we'll come back and we'll see what she's like. Okay everybody, we're back. God, that was a bit stressful, but it's done. If we just clear some of this rubbish out of the way that we don't need, and we can also get rid of some of these tools. If I just run it through my fingers, nothing's binding, it all feels nice and free. So hopefully it should all work absolutely fine. I might change this wire here, this pickup wire, because I don't think it's going to be long enough to reach the 8-pin socket. Either that or I might extend it slightly. But everything seems to be okay. Everything has been screwed in, nothing feels loose, so everything should hopefully be fine. There's enough rumbling on. Let's get the loco back together, get it wired up, get it on the track, and now we'll see what she's like with the new motor. Here we are, we're finally back. It's taken a little while to get this far, but we're finally here. Everything's been wired in. As we can see, the new socket has been wired in, and it's definitely, as I'm sure it's already obvious, there's definitely it looks like there's more space in here now. There's definitely less wire taking up space, which is very, very good. And the new sockets will hopefully make things a bit easier wiring stuff up, such as lights and everything as well now. So all we need to do now is give her a test. We'll see how fast she runs. If need be, I will change the CVs to slow her down so that there's less currents going to the motor. But anyway, let's give her a test and see what she's like. Okay, so here we are over the layout. So if we just put the loco on, and there shouldn't be any problems. Well, nothing shorting, so that's a good start. So I can hear the chip getting power. Let's just make sure all of the wheels are on. They look to be, so if we just select her number, and we'll give her as little power as we can, and we'll see what speed she does. Wow, that is incredibly smooth. And the other direction? Wow, that is absolutely fantastic. Completely silent and incredibly smooth. Let's give her a bit more power. That is fantastic. Obviously, you are going to still get noise from the gears, but there's definitely less noise overall, because obviously you haven't got the noise of the typical ring filled motor or pancake motor, so it's definitely quieter. Bring it back this way. That is absolutely fantastic. She sounds a little bit grindy still. But I will give the Loco a quick running in period. I'll probably do about 20 minutes in each direction or so, just to get the motor ran in. But obviously I don't want to run it for too long, because I don't want it to getting too hot. But if we put the body back on, we'll get a few shots of her running, and then we'll get leave her to run in. Overall, I think we can say that's been very successful. She's much, much smoother. She's definitely quieter, which is, I suppose, the main reason for doing this as well. But overall, absolutely fantastic. Hopefully, with an even better decoder, she should run smoother. But I really just don't know what to say. I just can't believe how well she's running now. Definitely worth upgrading the motors in your Lima Locos if you're not happy with them. This upgrade is so simple. Literally all you need to do is get the converter kit, take out the old motor, trim down the new gear, fit the new motor, wire it up, and you're done pretty much. That's literally all you need to do. It's so simple. But I think the next thing to do now will be to fit her with lights. So that should hopefully be the next part. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next part of the Lima Class 37 project.